Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX Product Marketing Team, and today I'm going to be going over a few tips that can greatly improve your productivity when using NX Join. To begin, we are starting with a coffee machine, and we are going to take a look at the fasteners attached to the front screen. The first thing you may notice when looking at this part is that we do have two fasteners already attached to the screen. However, the bottom of the screen is missing its fasteners. We can add these fasteners efficiently by utilizing the Transform Join tool. Transform Join tool allows users to select a number of joins and then either mirror or translate them across the part. In uniform parts, this is very useful as it can save loads of time while ensuring that the joins are consistent throughout. Additionally, you may also notice under settings that there are boxes labeled Associative, Load Hardware, and Create Hole. The Associative box determines whether new joins will change when alterations are made to the original. The Load Hardware and Create Hole options are self-explanatory, but these customization settings can greatly improve design efficiency. Now that our fasteners have loaded in with the hardware, the next two things we will look at involve verifying our joins came out as expected. We are going to use the Analyze Connections tool to see if our fasteners work as we intended. The Analyze Connections tool is a good way to review which bodies are connected by a join. As I select our two new joins and click Perform, a new group of joins pops up under Results. When I expand this selection, you can see a list of the bodies joined as well as which fasteners were a part of this group. Alternatively, if you'd prefer these fasteners to be sorted individually, we can uncheck the group results and each fastener is given its own section, but still shows the bodies they connect. The last tool that we will explore is actually not a direct part of NX Join, but can be a great instrument for analyzing if your joins will be feasible given certain standards for production. To start, I'm going to open Developer from the top of the screen and choose Setup Tests under Checkmate. As you can see, there is a wide variety of options, but we are going to scroll to the bottom of this list where we will find a tab specifically for joins. Here we can find a variety of tests that will analyze different aspects of our joins. I'm going to select two that explore how far our fasteners stick out from the screen's face. Once these have been selected, the next thing we can do is customize our target values for each test. When doing this, we also have the option to choose if our test flags mistakes as errors, warnings, or info messages. Once this has been determined, we can run our test by clicking Execute Checkmate Tests. After clicking Execute, an information box populates in telling us how the test performed. You can see both were successful, and when I close out the Setup Test box, the test results are also displayed under HD 3D Tools on the left of the screen. To review what we went over in this video, we began by translating our fasteners utilizing the Transform Join tool. After that, we took a deeper look at our new fasteners with the Analyze Connections tool. And finally, we finished things up by taking a look at the capabilities offered by Checkmate Tests for joins. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.